summer, I learned what science is really about. I spent the summer as an intern at the Monterey Institute for Research in Astronomy, where I worked on a small spectrograph and learned how to translate the light from distant stars into a graph that can actually be used to analyze the elements in those stars. Essentially, spectroscopy is a subset of astronomy that takes light from distant stars and breaks it apart like a prism would into all the different wavelengths of light from red to blue. When you do this precisely enough with a couple different lenses and such, certain dark lines appear called absorption lines. Each of these lines signifies something about what elements the star contains. Basically, different elements absorb different wavelengths of light. So just by looking at a star's light, you can see what it's made of. And there are so many stars out there that it's not even all that difficult to find one that's never been thoroughly analyzed. You could learn something about a star that no one else in the world knows. Of course, all of that analysis takes a great deal of specialized knowledge about spectroscopy, which I didn't have the time to learn in 3 months. So I didn't actually do any of this analysis. I just made it possible. Specifically, what I did was take this spectrograph, make it work by figuring out the right parts for cameras and connectors and such, focus it, and so on, until it was ready to go on the telescope. Then, one night, we actually put it on the telescope and looked at stars, which was really cool. I was taking spectra of stars, spectra which astronomers could use to figure out what the star was made of and even a lot about the size and shape of the star. And this was something maybe only a handful of people had ever done with these specific stars. That's when I learned something about practical science versus the theoretical answers in the back of the book stuff you learn in school. I didn't go back on the telescope the next night or the next. No. For the rest of the summer, I worked on reducing the data from that one night, those 10 stars. It's a lot more analysis and less observation than I had imagined, because in school, you go straight from observation to conclusion without looking at the enormous amount of analysis that goes in between. So, for the remainder of the summer, I worked with a program called MIDAS, which translates spectra from something looking like this to something more like this. I didn't spend all of my time observing or working out which stars I would observe. It was spent on the data after the observations were done. And I didn't even do all of that analysis. That I just made it possible. No one's actually analyzed the data I've made yet. There could be information lurking in those graphs that no one knows right now. And that's what's so cool about science. There's so much we don't know. And it's stuff like this that helps us learn. Spectroscopy, for me, which is such a small corner of astronomy, which is just a tiny subset of science, which is such a minuscule portion of all the things that could be known. If you go out on a dark night and look up at the sky, how many stars do you think you could see? It looks like there are millions, but if it's dark and you're away from city lights and there are no clouds, the human eye, unaided, can see maybe 3,000 stars. Of course, telescopes help us see many, many more, both the 100 million in our galaxy and billions more in others. And each star has a spectrum, and each planet around those stars have spectra. And even if human civilization lasted a million years, we couldn't analyze them all. There will always be more to learn. That's what's so cool about science. Science from scire to know. But science isn't really about what we know. It's about what we don't know. We can never know everything. But science will never, ever stop trying. Thank you.